Hello children, we'll start today our new topic, that is menstruation. What is menstruation and how to calculate menstruation? We will go through in this topic. Introduction. Perimeter is the distance covered along the boundary, forming a closed figure when you go round the figure once. Perimeter means if you see the garden in your house or the playground in your school, if you go to a one round, single round, that is called perimeter. The outer boundary of the surface is called the perimeter. Perimeter of rectangle and square we will see now. Perimeter of the following regular figures is as follows. Here I have taken rectangular picture, Nana. For example, we will see how to find the perimeter for this picture. Perimeter of a rectangle. A rectangle has four sides. Out of these four sides, opposite sides are equal in length. Let the sides be A and B. Right, Nana? We are having four sides. Yes or no? 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are our four sides. If you observe, the opposite lines are equal. The opposite lines are equal. That's why we'll take them as A and B. We'll take it as A and B. Length as A, breadth as B. Perimeter of a rectangle is equal to sum of all sides. Sum of all sides means what is meant by sum here? Sum means we have to add all the sides. Sum means addition. We have to add all the sums, all the sides. Not sums, Nana. We have to add all the sides. Now, A plus B plus B. So, how many times we are observing A here? We are observing A for two times. So, we have to write it as 2A plus. How many times we have seen B here? We have seen B also for two times, right? 2B. Now, what is common here? We are having common number, that is 2. So, take out 2 a side out and write in brackets A plus B. That is nothing but our 2A plus 2B. 2 is taken as common and in bracket we have written A plus B. So, we will multiply 2 along with A and 2 along with B. The formula for perimeter of a rectangle is equal to 2A plus B. What is our formula? 2a plus b. So, we get perimeter of a rectangle is equal to length plus breadth, that is equal to again plus length plus breadth. So, 2 times of length and 2 times of breadth. We will see one more example here. Perimeter of a square. A square has 4 sides and they are equal in length. Let the side of a square be L. If we observe the picture what we have taken here, its sides are all equal. All the four sides are equal. This is called a square. Now, perimeter of a square is equal to sum of the lengths of the sides of the square. What are our sides here? These are our sides. All the sides are equal here now. 2, 3 and 4. These are our four sides. Those are all equal in size. Now, what we have to do? What is meant by sum here? Sum is nothing but adding all the lengths of the sides of a square. We have to add. Sum is nothing but do addition. Do addition here. Now, what is our addition here? We have to add 4 is all together. L plus L plus L plus L. How many sides we are having? 4 sides. That's why I mentioned 4 before our length. 4 into L. That is the formula of the perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square is equal to 4 into length of a side. Perimeter of a rectangle means 2 into L plus B. 2 times of length and breadth. What is perimeter of a square? 4 times of length. We'll just go through a small video so that we can easily understand how to find the perimeter of a rectangle and how to find the perimeter of a square. Now go through the video. Now we have seen how to find perimeter of a rectangle and how to find a perimeter of a square. Now we learn how to find perimeter of a equilateral triangle. Why we are calling it as equilateral triangle? Because if you observe, the three sides of the triangle are equal when the three sides of the triangle are equal, we will call it as equilateral triangle. Now we'll see, a triangle has three sides. An equilateral triangle is a triangle with three sides which are equal in length. Let the side of an equilateral triangle be of Z. Now we are just given a name to the side, that is Z. Equilateral triangle means, as I told you before, all the sides are equal. Now, how to find perimeter of this? Finding perimeter of an equilateral triangle is equal to sum of the lengths of the sides of the square. How we have done in the form of square? Here also we have to add all the sides of the triangle. For triangle, how many sides we are having? Only three sides. That is, what the name we have given for each side? Z. Z plus Z plus Z. So how many Z's are there? How many sides are there? Three sides are there. So what we name them? We name them as Z. That is equal to 3Z. Now, perimeter of an equilateral triangle is equal to 3 into length of a side. This is how we are going to find perimeter of an equilateral triangle. Children, we have seen how to find perimeter of a rectangular shapes, square shapes and equilateral triangle shapes. Now, we are going to learn how to find perimeter of a regular closed figures. What are meant by regular closed figures? We will see here. Regular closed figures. Figures having all the sides of equal length and all the angles of equal measure are known as regular closed figures. Therefore, a square and an equilateral triangle are regular closed figures. Not only a square, even if you take your rectangular picture also, we can find the regular closed figure perimeter. Now we will see here example of perimeter of a regular closed figure. How we are going to find it? Find the perimeter of each of the following figure. Each of the following figures. Now, I have taken first a rectangular bit along with the equilateral triangle bit. Now, if you see here, what are the lengths here? This and this is the length. So, what are our lengths? Length is equal to 4 centimeters. Right now, what is our breadth here? Our breadth is 1.5 centimeters. Breadth is equal to 1.5 centimeters. Right now? Now, what is your equilateral triangle length of a side? Length of a side for equilateral triangle. What is it? It is 2.5 centimeters. Length of a equilateral side is equal to 2.5 centimeters. Right or wrong? You may get, how you got 2.5 here? Because you have seen only 0.5 and 0.5 centimeters. Because if you observe here, this breadth is we have taken as 1.5 centimeters, right? For this 1.5 centimeters, we have to add 0.5 plus 0.5. Then you will be getting the length side as 2.5 centimeters. Now what you have to do? You have to add all the sides of the picture. Now you may take directly, separately or directly. If you want to take directly, how you will take? You have to add all the lengths. That is 4 plus 4, 8. 1.5 plus 1.5, that is 3. 4 plus 3 is equal to how much? 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. Now, what you have to do? You have to add plus 2.5 plus 2.5. But coming to the third side, you have to take only this 0.5 centimeters and 0.5 centimeters. Why? Because you have already added 1.5 centimeters here in the rectangular area. Now you will be taking only 0.5 centimeters plus 0.5 centimeters, which is out of the rectangular picture. So 0.5 centimeters plus 0.5 centimeters, you will be getting it as 1 centimeter. Now add all together. When you are adding 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 5, it is 13 centimeters. This is how you are going to find the perimeter of a regular closed figure. We are going to solve one example by seeing the picture here. So what is the picture here? We are having the picture of a ship. Now what we are going to find by observing this picture, we will see. What is our problem now? What is the length of the wooden strip required to frame a photograph of length and breadth 32 centimeters and 22 centimeters respectively? So we have seen the picture of a shape that is drawn. Now we have to fit this picture in a frame. What is meant by frame, Nana? If you see your photographs, your photo will be inside, the frame will be out of your photo, right? That area we have to find. That is called the perimeter. The outer boundary is called the perimeter of the picture. That is called the frame. Now, they have given here the length and breadth of the wooden frame. What is our length here? The length of the wooden frame is 32 centimeters. What is the breadth here? It is 21 centimeters. Now, we will see our solution. The length of the wooden strip is given by the perimeter of the photograph, as perimeter is the sum of all sides. Since the photo frame is rectangular in shape, its perimeter is. What is the formula for perimeter of a rectangle? We already discussed, that is 2 into L plus B. What is our length here? 32 centimeters. What is our breadth here? 21 centimeters. Now, 2 into 32 plus 21. We have to apply in the formula. Now, when you are adding 32 plus 21, you will be getting your answer as 53. Now, this 53 should be multiplied by 2 for finding the perimeter. When you are multiplying 2 with 53, you will be getting your answer as 106 centimeters. 106 centimeters. Therefore, the length of the wooden strip required is 106 centimeters. The wooden strip will be straight. We will be bending it according to our picture frame. So, we need 106 centimeters length strip to frame our picture. Now we will see one more example here. The perimeter of a regular pentagon is 100 centimeters. This is our pentagon. Pentagon means we will be having 5 sides for the pentagon. How long is each of its side, considering we have to find? Pentagon is having 5 sides, Nana, and 5 sides is called the perimeter of a pentagon. Now they have given here perimeter. What is perimeter? It is 100 centimeters. Perimeter of a pentagon is 100 centimeters. Now we'll see our solution. Pentagon is a polygon with 5 sides of equal length. So if you observe 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, all the sides are equal. So what is perimeter? Perimeter is equal to sum of all sides, that is equal to 5a. Now, what is our perimeter? It is 100 centimeters. We have to find only our side, that is A. We have to find. We have to find only A. When we want to find only A, this phi will be coming to a side in the form of division. We have to do division with the total perimeter what they have given. So the given perimeter is 100. So this 100 should be divided by number of sides, that is 5. When you are dividing 100 by 5, what will be your answer? Your answer will be 20 centimeters. Now, the length of each side of the pentagon is 20 centimeters. If you want, you can check out now. So, each side is 20 centimeters. How many sides we are having in a pentagon? That is 5. So, 20 should be multiplied by 5. What will be your answer? The answer will be your same perimeter given in the question. That is 100 centimeters. That is 100 centimeters. These are all called regular closed figures. But how we are going to find irregular pictures? First, suppose this is my picture now. I want to find the perimeter of this picture. How you are going to find? What you are going to do? You are going to divide them into square boxes. You have to divide them into square boxes. Then you have to count how many square boxes are there. If suppose this is my picture and all are divided into square boxes. Now I want to find the perimeter. So each square box consists one, right? 1 centimeter. So how many boxes are there here? You count that first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So my answer will be 8 centimeters. This is how we are going to calculate the perimeter of an irregular shapes. We'll just go through a small video to find how we are going to identify the perimeter of a irregular shapes. Go through the video now.
Perimeter. Perimeter is the distance around a shape or space. Finding perimeter isn't just for squares and rectangles. You can find the perimeter of any shape or space. This is how you can do it. You count the side of each unit that is on the outside of the shape or space. Now let's try it and see how it works. Remember, we are counting the sides of the square units that are on the outside of our shape. Let's try it one more time. Let's try it one more time. What is perimeter? Perimeter is the distance around a shape or space.
Now we have learned how to find perimeter of a rectangle, square, irregular shapes, regular shapes, equilateral triangle, right? Now we learn how to find area of a rectangle and area of a square. So, as we all know that a square has four sides and all the sides are equal, right? This is a square and all the sides are equal. What is the formula for perimeter of a square? It is 4 times of the sides, that is 4 into L or 4 into S we can tell. But coming to finding area of a square, what we have to do, we will see here. Area, the amount of surface enclosed by a closed figure is called its area. Area means the complete picture which is occupying the space is known as a area of that picture. First, suppose this is a square and the square total space occupied the picture of a square, that total area is known as the total amount of area occupied by the square picture is known as the area. First, suppose if you are taking a book, you are placing on the desk, the book, the space occupied the book is called the area occupied by the book. The space where you are sitting, you are occupying your space on the bench, that is called the area of the space occupied by you. Means the amount which we are using, that is known as the area of the object. Now, how to calculate this area? For calculating area of a square, what we have to do? We have to multiply side into side. If you multiply two sides, is enough mark for finding area of the square. We have to multiply any two sides because all the sides are equal. That's why we have to multiply any two sides. So our answer will be L square. Area of the square is equal to side into side, that is equal to L square. Now, area of a rectangle. We know that area of a rectangle. A rectangle will be having two lengths and two breadths, right? Now, perimeter of a rectangle is calculated by 2 into L plus B. There we are adding L plus B for 2 times. That's why we have written formula as 2 into L plus B. There we added length and breadth and multiplying it by 2. But in finding area of a rectangle, we have to multiply length into breadth. We have to multiply length and breadth. We'll see here how to identify our length and breadth along with the perimeter. Now, what is the sum here? The area of a rectangular garden 50 meters long is 300 square meters. Find the width of the garden. In our question, they have given only the length of the rectangular space and they have given total area of the garden. Now, we have to find our width of the garden. What is our solution now? How we are going to solve this? Let the width of the garden be B meters. We don't know what is our width, so we will be writing it as B meters. Since the garden is rectangular in shape, we get area of a rectangular is equal to length into breadth. So what is our length here? Our length is 50 meters, that is multiplied by, we have taken breadth as B, that's why we will write it as B. 50 is multiplied with the B, that is 50 into B. Now we know what is the area of the rectangular garden. What is our area of the rectangular garden? It is 300. Meters. Now, what we have to do? We have to write 50 into B, that is 50 is our length. Length into breadth is equal to our area. 50 into B is equal to 300. Now, this 50 will be coming as division form to the side of 300. So, when we are taking LHS to RHS, it will become into the division form. That is, now we are finding our width as B is equal to 300 divided by 50. Now, when you are doing simplification here, 300 divided by 50, cancel the zeros. So, 0, 0 gets cancelled. 5 ones are 5, 6 are 30. Our breadth is equal to 6 meters. The width of the garden is now 6 meters. This is how we are going to calculate length or breadth when area of the garden is given. We will see one more example here. A floor is 5 meters long and 4 meters wide. It is rectangular floor, so our width will be 4 meters and length will be 5 meters. This is 5 meters length and this is 4 meters breadth. A square carpet of sides 3 meters is laid on the floor. So, a square carpet of 3 meters laid on the floor. This is 3 meters on all the sides. Now, find the area of the floor that is not carpeted. So, we have to find the area which is not covered with the carpet. This area we have to find. How we are going to find this area? For finding this area, first you have to calculate area of the rectangular floor. So, what is area of rectangular floor? Length into breadth, that is equal to 5 into 4. 5 fours are 20 meters square. Because both the units are in meters, we will be writing unit as meters square. Now, area of the square carpet, 2 into side. Two sides we have to multiply, side into side. Right, Nana? So, 3 into 3, that is equal to 9 meters square. Square formula is side 2 means what you have to write? You have to multiply side into side. Side into side, that is equal to 3 into 3, that is equal to 9 meters square. Now, the remaining area of the floor, how we are going to find? You have to minus area of the rectangular minus area of the square carpet. That is equal to 20 minus 9. So, the area which is not carpeted is 11 meters square. We'll see a small video so that you can easily remember how to find area of the square field and how to find area of the rectangular field. Children, we have learned many concepts in this chapter. So, go through all the concepts, practice them well, and then start doing your exercise. If you have any doubts in your exercise, you can get back to me. Hari Om. Thank you.